physician, quite the best looking doctor in the state. He looked after my physical condition, and his bedside manner was great. When I'd gaze up and see him there above me, looking less like a doctor than a Turk, I was tempted to whisper, "Do you love me? Or do you merely love your work?" He said, "My bronchial tubes were entrancing. My epiglottis filled him with glee. He simply loved my larynx and went wild about my pharynx, but he never said he loved me. He said my epidermis was darling and found my blood as blue as can be. He went through wild ecstatics when I showed him my lymphatics, but he never said he loved me. And though no doubt it was not very smart of me, I kept a racking my soul to figure out why he loved every part of me, and yet not me as a whole. With my esophagus, he was ravished, enthusiastic to a degree. He said it was just enormous, my appendix vermiforous, but he never said he loved me. He said my cerebellum was brilliant, and my cerebra far from NG. I know he thought a lot of my medulla oblongata, but he never said he loved me. He said my maxillaries were marvels, and found my sternum stunning to see. He did a double hurdle when I shook my belt and girdle, but he never said he loved me. He seemed amused when he first made a test of me to further his medical art, yet he refused once he fixed up the rest of me to cure that ache in my heart. And so he lingered on until morning, yet when I tried to pay him his fee, he said, "Why, don't be funny, it is I who owe you money." But he never said he loved me. He loved my sinuses and spleen, every organ in between, every muscle, every